Hi, I'm Alice Bull, and I run the Scrapbook. I have scrapbookwonderland.com, that's my blog, and then I also run the ScrapHappy membership group. And I have many of my ScrapHappy family members with me here today, which is really exciting. But I also have other people that are joining us that might not be familiar with what I do. I've been a scrapbooker for, my son just turned 18, as you will see in my photos later on today. He just turned 18, so I've been scrapbooking for 18 years now, which is a long time, but it's very exciting because along the way, I keep finding new things that keep me energized to do my scrapbooking, and I continue to love it. So I think that that makes it a really fun way to get, you know, to get my crafty energy out. But I also enjoy telling the stories. And I find that, you know, even though when I first started scrapbooking years and years ago with Creative Memories, I wasn't a consultant, but that's how I was introduced to it. They said, journal your stories, write down your stories, like write down your memories. You need to journal. But I had a hard time connecting with it. And I tended to make pages that did not have a lot of journaling. Like my idea of journaling was labeling the photos and listing who was in the photos. And, you know, it's like, okay, my journaling has progressed from there, but I really enjoy it now, like going back to the pages and adding just a little bit more detail when I can, or looking at the pages where I really did a good job with the journaling, because it really helps those memories come alive. And that's exactly what I'm looking for, is to bring back those good memories. And, you know, it's not like I only scrapbook really positive things. There's a few less happy things that sneak into my books too. But I think that by scrapbooking, I'm able to focus on those good memories. So that's kind of me and a little bit of my philosophy for scrapbooking. I like to play. I like to get creative. But I also like to keep things simple. So I kind of put my hand in every pot and like to play with a lot of different styles. And one thing that's been really great for that is the ScrapHappy membership group, because we do a lot of different things. We have a lot of different types of scrapbookers. So we have traditional 12 by 12 scrapbookers. We have people that are doing art journaling. We have people that are doing digital scrapbooking. We have people that are kind of doing hybrid and doing different sizes of books. And it's just amazing because you kind of see how everybody else is working this craft and making it work for them. And I love that so much. Okay, so the chat is quiet today, which is okay. So in case you're not familiar, there is a chat at the bottom of the screen. You can pop it up on the side, unless you're on a mobile device, and then you can't watch and chat at the same time. It just doesn't work. But yeah, we're going to get started. So every month, I am so excited that we have a sponsor for this, which is Gossamer Blue. And if you're not familiar with Gossamer Blue, they are a scrapbook kit supplier. And they actually have bringing a few new things into their shop. So if you haven't seen, they have a few new items in their shop that you might be curious to check out. So it's just gossamerblue.com. Maybe I should type that in the chat here. Gossamerblue.com. And yeah, they have, but one of the things they specialize in is scrapbooking kits. So they have a monthly main kit. They call it the main kit, which is like the kind of 12 by 12, or, you know, the scrapbooking kit. And then they also have a monthly life pages kit, which includes like little cards and embellishments for doing your pocket page scrapbooking. Along with your subscriptions to those, you also get digital downloads. And these are the two digital downloads that go with today's. I printed them off. So I've got the main kit principles here, and this is the Life Pages kit principle. So I've printed those off because I never quite know where the inspiration is going to lead as I get started. I'll probably start today with my main pages, or like the main kit, and then I'll move into the Life Pages. So let's have a peek and see what is in this fabulous package, right? So I'm wondering, is anybody else here using a Gossamer Blue kit today? Because they are quite fabulous. Also, at about the halfway mark in this, somewhere around the middle, when I finish my first page, before I move into the second one, I'll do a quick draw, and everybody that's present can be entered to win one of the kits. And sometimes, it just kind of depends on what Lori has to send out. Sometimes it's a Life Pages kit, and sometimes it is a main kit. She kind of gets to surprise you with a lovely prize, but I know that she ships them out really fast, because usually before a week is over, I've got the person saying, "Oh, I got my kit, and it's beautiful." So I'm excited. Always excited to hear that. Okay, so let's have a look in this main kit. And they kind of have a few predictable things in their kits every month, which of course means patterned paper and a little bit of cardstock, and then the other little creative embellishments. And they mix and match between a couple of lines. They usually don't go like more than three lines that I've seen, but they'll be mix and match between a couple of different scrapbooking lines. Okay, so in here to start with, we actually have a couple sheets of cardstock. There's a white and a black, and they are basil, like textured cardstock. And then we also have our pretty paper. So I'm just gonna see if I can separate it by line. That might be easiest, so we can kind of see which came from which line here. Okay, so from the Fancy Pants, this is the Sweet Things by Amber Leva. And there's this crazy and beautiful pattern. It has reds and pinks and yellows on this black background. And on the back is this yellow, which has little cross, they're not crosses, they're like plus signs, I guess. And then there is this one from the same line, is this P.S. I love you. It says P.S. I love you all over it. It's super cute. And a nice plain red on the back. It's very plain. I know you can kind of see a little pattern through it, but that's just the light reflecting through. But it's heavy cardstock. It is a heavier cardstock. This one here is from this Sweet Nothings line, and it has little tiny little black dots on the white background, and then we have a stripe that brings in those same colors. So it has the red, yellow, a gray, and a pink on the stripes. And here on this one, we have the plain yellow. It's just simple, solid yellow. And then we have like a little floral pattern. So you can have a look at that. Really cute. And then the other line that they've included in here, so you kind of get a little selection of both. Okay, everybody's getting ready. Susan says, I've tried the Life Pages kit before, just ordered one or two. They're lovely. And Jacqueline says, I'm working on my page for a load. Anyone else scrapbooking along? And Brielle says she's getting ready to. And Allie says she's working on her load layout. And let's see, today is the 26th. That means we're working on pet today. I'm not actually working on a pet page today, but hopefully I'll get that one to later today. Okay, so this is super cute. This is from Simple Stories, Love and Adore line. This X's and O's page, I love it. The different patterns on the different letters, that's super cute. And then we've got this arrow paper on kind of a soft bluey on the back. Oh, that's super pretty. And we've got this arrows, and it has the word hello, love, adore, sweet, XO, and a few different things like that. And what a surprise, little plus signs on the back. So we tend to see these things come in spurts, and plus signs are the thing right now. Now have a look at this paper. Oh my gosh, like, is that not so pretty? I'm almost scared to cover it up. So this is it's like a stained glass almost look, but with like this painted watercolor in the back. I love it. And then some simple black and white stripes, but they're a little bit different than what you normally see because they have slightly different widths of the lines. So there's a bit of funky spacing going on, which I'm actually really liking that. And then the sweet, it's like a really curly handwriting, be mine, love, XOXO, different sayings like that on here with little hearts interspersed between them. So That's cute. And on the back, little pink hearts. Okay, so that's the paper that's in here. So now let's get on to the playful and fun little embellishments. We'll have a quick look at the printable sheet. So this is the main kit printable sheet. It's made by Tracy Reed. And if you don't, not familiar with her, she's a digital designer. You can find a lot of her things at, the Sweet Shop, I think, Sweet Shop. I'd have to look that one up, but I'm pretty sure that's where she has a lot of her kits that she makes. She makes digital kits, and they're amazing, super amazing. I don't digital scrapbook, but I actually have a couple of her kits because I've used little bits along the way. So I think that tells you how good they are. When the non-digital people, you're like, I need to have some of that because I need to play with it. So it's a whole bunch of different little tag boxes, and like this is super cute because it's like this ombre effect little spot where you can put in your journaling, and it's like there's six of them in there, and little sayings at the bottom, just as sweet as can be, so photogenic, sending all my love and happy heart, all you need is love, I love you bunches, today we're making memories. So lots of great little sayings and banners and just cute little embellishments that we can use. And when you have your kit at the beginning of the month, when they mail out the kits, they send out the digital files in an email, and then you just download that. So it works really good. Okay, so in here, we've got some little wooden embellishments. Been seeing quite a few wooden embellishments still, like the little wood veneers. And oh my gosh, look at this. Okay, so it's the word February, but it has like those marquee letter look with the little dots all over them. Super cute. Brielle said, I was working on a different non-prompt page, but now I'm distracted by looking for cute kitty pictures. I love this prompt. So glad that I can see the prompts again. I was locked out while on vacation. Oh, she had no Wi-Fi. Oh my gosh, that would have been super sad. And to the stars and back, and these are the best days. Sorry, that's like super awkward the way I was holding them. There, those are cute. They're kind of big too, like they're not super tiny like some of the little embellishments. Maybe I should put these back in the bag so I don't lose all the bits on my desk, which is getting way cleaner, by the way. My room is getting a lot cleaner. Okay, so in here we've got some sticker sheets from Simple Stories. It's from That Love and Adore. And, there's a little tiny alpha in there. There's some little words. There's like a lot of options in there. Let me have a look. I'll open them up and we'll have a quick peek at that. Because if I have a better idea of what's in the kit, then I'll know what I have to work with. So here we have some cute little embellishments. Oh, I see Christina is here. Haven't seen her yet. And some cute little words. These are sweet. There's lots of little word things. Hi, Diane. She says, I got here late. Okay, so this is the kit from Gossamer Blue, and that's what I'm going to be using for scrapbooking. Oh, Brielle's holding stuff up here too. Okay. There's alphas in here. They're little black letters and some little tags and labels. And some cute little colored like word bits. So it's a very love themed kit. And I think I will be doing a layout today that is love themed, but I'll also be doing another, like my pocket page today is not love themed. But sometimes the pocket pages kits aren't quite the same as what this is, so they can have slightly different themes to them. Yeah, and these cute little rectangles, that's sweet. Okay, so that's what's in the sticker kits from Simple Stories. There's also these cute little enamel dots. Oh, Christina, everybody can see your kitty is so sweet. In here from the Sweet Nothings, we have sticky notes. And that would be perfect for adding just a little bit of journaling or having little banners and flags. And we have here from the Sweet Nothings, this whole die cut ephemera pack. And it has like a ton of little things, which I'll open up, but here's like a little peek of all the stuff in there. There's little Eiffel Towers, hot air balloons, banners, letter, like there's a letter, like an envelope, and then there's like a post box, and yeah, lots of cute little pieces in there to play with. There's also a Sweet Nothings piece, a roll of washi tape, and this one has those little plus signs on it. And then the alpha letters, and they look really thick and really messy, but if you look at them up close, they're actually quite thin and fine letters. So you can see how thin and fine they are. And I'll probably use those on the page today, because that looks good. Okay, so now it's time to get started. So I'll show you one of the pictures that I was hoping to do. It's in this fancy MGM Grand. I just came back from a quick trip to Vegas where we actually went to a wedding, which was super fun. I've never been to a Vegas wedding before. And, well, a sort of quick trip. We rode my husband's small airplane, so that made it not so quick of a trip. Let's just say that and leave it there. But we went for dinner the one night after we went to the Ca Cirque du Soleil show. We went to an Italian restaurant and had dinner out, and we had our picture done there. And I thought that this was kind of fun, and I thought, why not? So I think that that's the picture I'm going to work with. And being that there's so many love embellishments and papers, this is kind of like the perfect thing. But while I'm here, like other pictures that I'm hoping to get scrapbooked as well, we went to the Titanic exhibit. They have this massive Titanic exhibit over at the Luxor Hotel, and they get you to pose. Oh, isn't that great? I love it. I'm the king of the world. Yeah. So I thought that was wonderful. And of course he was like standing there like, okay, go ahead. And you're just in front of a green screen and they have this little white part of the front of the ship there for you to pose with. And then they stand you in front of this green screen kind of wall and they put that picture in front of a few different backgrounds. And you're going to laugh when you see this picture because here we are. This is in front of the grand staircase, which I thought was wonderful. But look at my husband. Yes, he is rolling his eyes. And I said, I'm buying that picture just because you rolled your eyes, and I'm not going to let you live that down. So how dare you wreck my picture like that? But no, it was really fun. I thought the exhibit was fascinating and I really loved it. And of our little group that popped over there to check it out, I took a long time and everybody else was kind of like done and going, when is she finished? But that's just how I am. Okay, so with this picture being black and white, I think that allows me to really get playful with the kinds of colors and stuff I want to put into this layout. I like the idea of using this, but I think we just cover up way too much of that pretty pattern. I like that XOXO. I don't know if it's like formally enough for this look of the photo. P.S. I love you. I think it's too wild. Too wild for me. I like the look of that. I like the look of the black dots. I like this little floral. And I thought I was going to use this paper, actually, when I saw it. I'm like, oh, that'll be the winner. But it's looking almost too busy. And I like the little pink. So I think I'm going to try to use a blend of these. I think I'll try to use a blend of those four. And of course, I still have the cardstock to work with. And I will, from time to time, pull something else out of my stash that I want to add that I know, like, oh, this is the perfect little piece. But generally, I'm just working with the kits because they're so easy to work with. yeah, the perfect, Brielle says, the perfect photo for that kit. And Christina said, perfect for the theme. Okay, got to keep the evidence, awesome, you bet. I'm like, if you're going to roll your eyes at in my photo, then I will have that forever. I think I'm going to mat this photo on the black first because I really like the look of that. And let's have a look here. Oh, that's funny. I just realized I haven't pulled the plastic off of my paper trimmer. And my husband obviously hasn't seen it on here because he's super crazy for that. He always pulls that plastic sheet off of things. And sometimes I'm like, you know, leaving it on there to protect my surface. And he's like, oh, look, this has got plastic on it. Rip. I'm like, why does that bug me so much when he does it? But he does lots of other things that are wonderful. So, you know, I guess I can get over him peeling the plastic off of things. Okay, so I've matted the picture onto some black first, and I like how that's going to give me a little bit of definition between my layers here. And I think I'll just stick this photo right onto the mat right now. And get that part done. Yeah, when he saw the photographer come around to the table as we were at the restaurant, he was like, oh God, because he knew that I was going to say, yeah, take our picture. So he was groaning before things even got started. Okay. Not sure if this. I'm liking the look of this a little bit more. Sure, we'll pull them up to the side. Cool. And maybe I'll just do it as a strip. Okay. Cool, about that wide. Okay, so I've done a strip that's about 5 inches wide that's going to go behind this photo, just like that. And I'm going to keep a lot of this pink in there, which I think is really pretty. I might actually frame this. I'm looking at that, I like the idea of that. So, how big a frame do I want? Maybe a... all the way down to 10. That could work. Okay, so I'm going to use a 10 by 10 square for my frame. Oh yeah, and this is the paper that had that pretty little, pretty paper on the back. I might actually use a strip of that. That would be good. And that's going to go on this paper. So I'll cut the strip off of here. Ooh, white. It's always the hardest to line the strip up to where it needs to be cut off. I guess I could use my 12-inch marking tape. Okay, so that's good. I think it's going to be on here like this. I don't think I need to like mat that anymore. I like this across here, but maybe... maybe just to there. Yeah, I think I'll cut an inch off of that. This is flowing quite well. Wait till I get to the embellishment part and it's like, all the gears come to a grinding halt. It's funny, I'm better at designing the base of the page than I am at adding embellishments to a layout. And I think everybody has, well, maybe not everybody, but lots of people have a sticking point where you kind of get to this point and it's like, oh, I just, where do I go from here? Okay, so I like this. That's looking good. So can you see that in here? Maybe if I slide over a little bit. Let me turn that. So that looks pretty good. I'm liking the look, the overall look of that. And I think if I might cut some of these out for on here too. I really liked this ombre thing, but I don't think that it's quite right to go on this page. I'm gonna cut out this little thing that says love this. It's like just a little black banner. Is anybody here that's working on their load pages? If you're working on your layout a day this month, anybody here that's still on track for getting every layout done? Because I'm always curious to see how many people we have that are getting all pages done. I had a really strong start to the month myself, and things kind of fell apart. So I'm not one of those people this month, but I can live with that. Okay. Grateful for us. I don't really want to use yellow. Just as sweet as can be. Pulls a little bit of the red in there, maybe. Maybe a plain banner. Okay. I think I'll use my trimmer so I can cut some straighter lines. So now it's just a matter of working up to the embellishment stage and trying to think of what I really wanted to say for journaling. I don't have a lot that I wanted to say for this one, but I've got to put something on there, and I think that just talking about what we did while we were there in Vegas will be good. I think I'll probably do a pocket page of a spread for the wedding. I don't have all of those photos printed yet, but we took a bunch while we were there. So I actually have access to a lot of the wedding pictures. So that'll be nice too. Okay. So let's put a little bit of, let's look and see how I can layer up some pieces. Okay, so I think it's time to dig into those awesome little packs of embellishments and think about all of this. My husband and I have actually been married for almost 20 years. In April, it will be our 20-year anniversary. So it's kind of exciting and crazy all at the same time that it's already been that long. Brielle says February load is a tough one for me because we always go on vacation, but I'm going to play along now till the end. Yeah. And honestly, like, I've taken some scrapbooking on the road. If you're at a place without Wi-Fi, obviously that definitely doesn't work. But it's funny how most places tell you nowadays that they have Wi-Fi. Whether it's actually good enough to actually use is the question. Oh, it's funny. I wasn't going to pull this yellow color in here, but I really like this little banner. Maybe I will pull a little bit of yellow into this. Who knows? Oh. With this little strip, that could actually help. Sealed with a kiss. It actually says this on this little thing, sealed with a kiss, and he's giving me a kiss, so I think that's gonna end up on the page for sure. So I'm just digging through this pile of lovely little embellishments and just kind of randomly kind of chucking them on the thing. And then we'll see. I can always move things around and, you know, change it. But Eiffel Tower on there. Sending all my love, but there's a couple of hearts, and so sweet. Maybe this is what I need to do all the time, is just like throw random stuff on here until I feel that I've made enough little piles, and that'll turn into a layout. Like, oh, I like that. Let me just check that on here. Because I'm actually liking some of this overall effect so far. Well, it turns out that little bit of yellow is really growing on me. Surprise, surprise. Oh, that looks like a little... Yeah, this is a different shade of yellow on these because that would have been good to use those like a little enamel dots, but they're so, it's such a different yellow, which is funny because this is from the Simple Stories. Oh no, this one isn't, is it? These ones are from the other company. Okay, so the yellows aren't quite the same between these two kits. Okay. And so let's think about what I want to add for journaling and how I'm going to get that added. Now that I've played with some embellishments, it's time to start thinking about my words. Where's my little notepad? I usually sketch out my words on a notepad that I usually have sitting right here. Let me have a look. I'll just grab a sheet. Okay. And then that's cute. They have little paper bits in here that look like little sequins, which I thought was kind of funny and cute. If you add like a little bit of shiny glitter or something like that, they will look like actual sequins, I think. I might throw some of those on here at the end. Okay, so titles. Where's the titles feeling? It's feeling like maybe down here. And I don't really have much of a title that I really... I'm open to title suggestions. Let's just say that. Christina says, I love yellow and pink. And oh, Brielle says there was Wi-Fi, but not for videos. Plus, I had to play on the beach every day, making memories for future scrapbooking. Oh, that's a hard life, having to play on the beach every day. She's nodding like, yeah, I agree. I love it. We haven't done a beach vacation for a while now, and I could definitely go for one of those. Okay. Oh, that's funny. There's like a little thing on here. It says 1+1, you and me. And I actually like that saying, that you and me. It's funny almost in a way. I almost want to stick you and I on here, which sounds awful grammatically, but my husband does, he uses I's and me's wrong all the time. It drives me nuts because I'm always correcting him. And it was funny because yesterday he actually caught me where I said it wrong. I'm like, oh my God, he's rubbed off on me. So it was terrible. No, you can't do that to me. So I think I'm going to go with that you and me. I kind of like that. Just checking the little wood embellishments, but I don't know. We'll see if those end up on here. But I like that you and me, so I think I'm going to go with that, and I'll use those black letters, and I'm going to do them at the bottom. I'm going to run them right over this strip because I like the way that turned out. So because I didn't stick everything down in the beginning, because I didn't know where this was going yet, I like to give myself options. What I usually do is take a quick picture with my phone, and then just that allows me to consult it when I go back to adding some random embellishments again, just in case I kind of don't see where I was going with it the first time. And I'll just try to keep my piles roughly together. But I think that this is looking pretty good. Oh. So I actually had a little shopping spree the other day where I went to a scrapbooking store. I don't know if anyone follows me on Instagram, but I shared a picture of my haul from the scrapbooking store. And I have been having the funnest time playing with stuff from my little haul that I did there. And one of the things I've created, I'll show you in a little bit, I started creating kind of like a bullet journal, kind of a planner, kind of a mishmash, just a chance for me to play with some of the things that I've seen that I've kind of wanted to play with for a while. So I've been having a lot of fun with that. And one of the things that I picked up were, I picked up these markers. And they're actually from Copic. They're Copic markers, but they're not like the coloring markers. They're black line markers, multi-liner is what they're called, Copic multi-liner. And they come in different widths. So that's what they are, is the Copic multi-liner. And so I got a 0.8, a 0.5, and a 0.1 for the different line widths. And they are so cool because you can actually... they're water and Copic proof. So when you draw your lines, you can easily color around your Copics with them, or else you can watercolor right over them and it doesn't bleed and get messy. And it's been a bit of a struggle for me to find something like that. I hadn't found something that kind of fulfilled that requirement. And so I'm super excited now that I have them because I'm having so much fun playing with that. I'm like, how have I not had this? And how have I been so behind? Because it's something that I'm really enjoying. It took me a while to get on to the whole watercolor thing. I didn't feel like I was, watercoloring kind of felt like something for artists, artistic people, like it's for artists and not for me. And it's what I do, fun and creative and stuff, sure. But I never felt like what I was doing was art. But I think my mind is opening a little bit more to the idea that I just feel like this is too low. So this adhesive is not a removable adhesive, but it doesn't stick at first, like super strong, so... If at first you don't succeed, peel it up and try again. Actually, I was hoping I would see the new glue dots adhesive there, but they didn't have it. And I have a confession. If you're in my ScrapHappy group, during our happy hour the other day, I forgot to do the draw for the January group challenge, where there was like a prize on the line if you shared a page that you'd made recently or something about happiness, or was that what the challenge was, about happiness? Anyways, and I had forgotten that I hadn't done the draw, totally missed it the other day, and I will do the draw and maybe I'll do like a little short video for us for that, so that I can get that done, because we actually have a sketch that I can put up, and then with the sketch that we have, I wanted to have a little challenge. We'll give a will give us a little bit of time for that. So I'm kind of excited. We all said, well said. There we go. Okay, so this is coming all back together. Maybe I don't need the heart there. Okay. Let's put this banner back on. I might need to look at my little picture again to see if I've kind of randomly looked into something that looks okay here. Okay, but let's have a look at these letters. Oh, and it has a really nice little ampersand in this alpha, so that's lucky. Or ampersand, I called it anversand, that's crazy. Yeah, an ampersand. So let's peel these up. I wonder if these letters will actually stick. Or if they're gonna be like a thicker that doesn't stick. They're very plasticky. Like these ones are, they're almost like a foamy, not foamy, like, what are those? Puffy, they're puffy. They're puffy letters, that's what they are, which is kind of neat. Because we see so many of those little puffy stickers in scrapbooking supplies right now, but I haven't seen a ton of puffy lettering. And something different. Oh, and I just noticed there's actually quite a few E's in this alpha. So I think they've gone and added a few extras in very common letters, or is it just, yeah, there's 1, 2, 3, there's 6 E's in this alpha, so that's kind of nice. And that was from that Sweet Nothings collection. Oh, I even call them puffy alpha stickers. There you go. I think I'm just going to stick those right down there. Looks good. Sorry, I'm thinking while I line them up. Apparently really hard. There we go. Cool. I like it. And let's add a couple of these things. Get them stuck down. My foam tape is right here. I think I'll pop up a couple of the little embellishment pieces just to make them, you know, a little bit higher on the page. A little bit of dimension. Good. I want the banner puffed up. I think it's kind of floppy. I don't know if I can pop it up very easily. Let's give it a try though. I think I'll like it a lot once I do it, so then I'll be happy I did. And just putting the little bits of the foam tape. I started using foam tape because I was a consultant with Close to My Heart, and I've tried going back to different foam pop-up squares, and I just haven't liked anything else quite as much as I've liked the foam tape. So even now, even though I'm not a consultant anymore, I still pick up the foam tape because I like the experience of using it, just because I have that control over how big of size, or like the size that I want for the piece that I'm adhering. And their foam tape is super sticky. So when I stick this on, I will be attempting to get it in the right place the very first time. Okay. So one Oh, we've got somebody that has their sound on. If you want to just hit the mute, that's helpful. Unless you want to say something, then go ahead and say stuff. I'm totally cool with that. And if somebody has something that they're wanting to show off, then I would love that. There we go. I'll have a... Oh, Christina, can I put you on audio too, Christina? Put you on the display share? Okay. I'll put her on a spotlight.
I haven't finished yet. I'm just having fun with you guys, but we just got back from Colorado, and this is in Idaho Springs, Colorado. It's a frozen waterfall. So I'm just having fun with blues and blacks.
I love it. I love it. Thank you so much. Anybody else wanting to share? It's all good. I'm very open to sharing. It makes it more exciting. We get to see some other stuff. So yeah, this is coming together pretty good. Okay, but I haven't done my journaling. Do you guys notice that I had left that out? Kind of forgot it. Okay. I need a little journaling box. Oh my gosh, I forgot about these cute little things. Too many adorable pieces, I tell you. Just want to use them all, and that doesn't really work very good. I don't think that's going to work very... Oh, we've got... Okay. So journaling, just want to put something like right here maybe, or I could put something right down here actually. That would be right there or there, I guess. Oh, that would be a little glaring. Okay, let's have a look at the backs of some of these papers. A little bit of red, not too bad. Could try it on the red, I guess. If I don't like it, I don't have to stick it down, right? Or I could just bring a little piece of white. Kind of like the idea of playing with the red, so I think maybe I'll chop a piece of that off and we'll give it a try out there. Oh, maybe I should have stuck those things down at the top a little bit more. Let's see, maybe I'll make it 3 inches. I'll go 3.5 because I can tuck it underneath and make something. Okay. Cool. And so let's take it down to there. What is that? About 3. I'll go 3.5 again. So I'm just cutting a little piece that I'm going to use to layer in there. I'm not sure if I super love it or not yet, but... Or if it just stands out way too much. So can you see the overall effect? What do you see when you look at this layout? Other than the cascade of embellishments. Oh, I think now that I've put this big red square on there, all you see is this big red box, you kind of lose the rest of the layout. So I think that the red is not a very good choice, even though I cut it all down. Oh, fancy scrapper. She said, love your blouse, Alice. Pretty colors like a scrapbook page. It's actually like a dress. I love dresses. It's like, I think they're super fun. And so other than the fact that I live where it's like super cold out, they're so fun and easy to wear. So I have a nice collection of dresses that I like to pull out, and I honestly wear them a lot. One of the worst things is in the summer when I want to be wearing my dresses all the time, I tend to be coaching swimming. And so I can't be out on the, I'm just going to make sure I've got some background noises coming in here. But so I don't want to be out on the pool deck wearing dresses. Like, that just doesn't work. So it kind of, my swim coaching that I love to do kind of interferes with my fashion. But in the end, it's all good. Okay, so let's have a peek here. So I know what size I wanted to make it now. So that's a good thing. 3 1/4, and I think I'll just cut a little tiny piece out of this rather than chop the whole page. Okay, so now that I've used the white, let's just compare this. I'll just put the red one over top. So if you can see, when you look at the layout with the red, which kind of seemed like it was going to work, you can see all you look at when you look at this page now is that big red square. But when I take that off and I have the white, it's not going to be as glaring, I think. So I like it. If I had a darker red pen for journaling, I'd maybe even do it in the red, but I don't think I do. So I think I'll just use like a black one. Okay. So what do I want to say for journaling? There's the question. Okay. So I'm going to be quiet for a minute because I can't talk and journal at the same time. I'll just be muttering and stuff. So continue to scrap alongside. I think somebody may have their audio on. You might want to go and click your mute button just so you don't have little background noises. Okay, so I wrote my journaling and I tried to write it kind of smallish, roughly in the shape of what I have. So I can see that it doesn't quite fit the way I wrote it. So, but I think like it's going to be close enough that I can generally make that fit. And I'm not going to draw lines on it. I think I'm going to just kind of wing it and see how that turns out. If I don't like it, I can always redo it. I like the idea of typing it, but I think that, I don't know, with this page, like with this the handwriting kind of feel. I like the kind of handwriting kind of look. I may actually matte this on the red. I think that little bit of red poking out will be actually super cute. So I might do that, where I matte this on the red. Wanted to make sure that we clear up some of the audio. Okay, so I saved a little bit of space at the bottom. I think I'm just gonna trim that off for the journaling. I had room for another line if I needed it, and I didn't quite, so that's good. And I'm gonna need a different size for this. I am gonna mat it on the red because I think I like the idea of that a lot. And that it has that separation between the other like handwriting kind of stuff that's right there. So I think that's good. And let's stick that down. And once I attach the rest of these embellishments, I think this page is nearing completion, which is crazy. This is the fastest one I've made on one of these, maybe. It just really seemed to come together nicely. Or maybe more time has slipped by than I realized. Oh, probably that's the answer. But yeah, I think that's good. This red is a little bit brighter than I wish it was. Sticking out a little bit more. Hold on a second. I'm just going to pull this up for a second. I'm going to actually ink this red a little bit, just to make it a little bit darker of a shade. Just so it's not sticking out and being glaring on the page. Good. Now here's a question. Oh, only a couple little spots of ink on my hands. Not bad. Awesome. Yep, that looks better already. Okay, let's attach some more little bits and get this page done. Yay, I'm really happy. It felt like it went fast. I guess in the beginning I did like the walkthrough of the kit. So, you know, we've been on here for about an hour, but you know, really the page didn't take that long, so. Ooh, must be cold outside. My furnace is kicking on again. I don't know if that makes a bunch of noise. Let me know if it does. I can turn it off. It's not actually cold in here. That's funny because I would find, like, I tend to be a very literal scrapbooker, and it's like, what on earth would I use a hot air balloon? I'm not like flying away in a hot air balloon, and it was like one of the first things I grabbed from this kit. I said, oh, I'm gonna stick that on there just like this. And I love it when I can get kind of out of my own set mind like that and actually use some of these super fun embellishments, because I don't think we're gonna see hot air balloons in our supply kits forever. Like, they've been kind of in our kits for a little while now, but I think by using them while they're current, yeah, it can kind of date your page a bit, but I think that it's fun to use those trends because there's always something new that's going to be coming out. Jacqueline says, I just did some journaling on my grandmother's typewriter. Does anyone else have a manual typewriter? I really miss spell check. Yes. I actually bought the Typecast typewriter from We Are Memory Keepers. And yes, it has a lot of the problems that people talk about, like the letters don't necessarily line up perfectly in a line. Spell check was an issue. One thing I've done with that is cut my journaling into strips so that I don't have to worry about the spell check. So I can type one line, and when I do the next line, I know it's going to be cut apart. So if I make a mistake in one of the lines, I, you know, can just cut that one off and just type out that new line. So strips work awesome for using the old manual typewriters. Or like really short journaling where you know that you can actually get everything on there. Yeah. So Allie said, I don't know what that means. O-M land? Oh, my land? I don't know. That's supposed to be the same. But so your grandmother would be thrilled. She says, it's so nice that you did that. I love that. Like, that you used her typewriter. Like, that's special. Becky says, I'm going to a hot air balloon festival in June. I can't wait to use my cute hot air balloon stuff. That would be really, really cool. One really fun thing, my one sister-in-law, well, my husband's sister-in-law, technically, had decided to take on a project the other year. His grandmother, like her husband's and my husband's grandmother, was turning 90. And for her birthday, she put together an album, and I helped with like some of the pages, but you know, like I did like maybe not even a quarter of the work for it. But she created this gorgeous album, and with the, when she was going through all the photos, because she had access to all these photos, I could not believe the places his grandparents had traveled to and where they had the activities they had done. And it was amazing and like inspiring. But the one thing, like, it was just like they were so adventurous. And one thing they had done was hot air ballooning. It was like, what? They did that? Yep, they did. They had also gone heli skiing. And like, I'm like, who does these things? They had done sailing trips where they sailed around like different places. They'd gone to the Bahamas. They'd sailed like, somewhere over in Europe. Just, it was amazing. Oh, up to Alaska. They had done sailing trips. Like, they were part of a sailing club for a while. And like, his grandpa wasn't like really well off, but I think he had done well in with his job, right? Like with his work, he had done fairly well with his work. And so that had led them to, but they were very thrifty people. Like I'm talking, like we rinse out the plastic Ziploc-y bags so that we can use them again kind of people, right? And it was just really exciting to see all the adventures that they had together over the years. And oh my gosh, it was just so inspiring to see. So I really, you know, gave me a whole new peek into their life. And, you know, they weren't my grandparents, so I didn't know a lot of their story. So that was really fun to learn more about them. Okay, so I've got, did I put this one on here? No, I don't know if it goes there. Maybe right there, that looks good. I've got lots of pieces on here now. Just take one last, maybe look through, and did I get that straight? It didn't look very straight. That's better. okay, so nothing's falling off. Yay. There we go. I think that came together pretty good. I thought I might use some of these little stickers, but I think that because I went into this little embellishment, sorry, I've got the stack of embellishments right here, because I ended up using so many of those little die cuts, I didn't need to use the stickers. I did use a couple pieces from the printables sheet that I had cut out. I've got some of those puffy letters on here. I could maybe throw a couple of these little dots on here. I'll do that. And I think one thing that I'm finding lately is that I'm a little more generous with myself about using some of my embellishments that I maybe would have hoarded a little bit more before. Because I've realized looking around my room and going through my supplies, because I'm actually systematically going through my stuff and cleaning out my scrapbook space, I'm starting to realize exactly how much stuff I have. It's a lot. But the good thing that's coming out of that is that I'm actually starting to use things a little bit more, and I'm being a little more generous with my supplies. Okay, no, there we go. That's going to be my finished product. Yay. Well, thank you. There we go. Becky had said, I type what I want on the computer and spell check there. Then I copy with my typewriter. I'm the worst speller, so I have to pre-write or my journaling will be full of mistakes. I also tend to skip words if I don't write it out first. And Braille said, that's a really good idea. I'm not a good speller either. That is a gorgeous page. Thank you. Lovely page. I'm learning not to save my stuff as well. As it is, I will never run out. Beautiful. Okay, so that's how that all came together with the first kit. I'm really kind of liking that. I'll just set it up here. I think it'll be kind of there in the background. So I have this Fred easel. That's what that thing is down there. They're apparently not available anymore, which is super sad. I had got one from a friend a couple years ago, and I have loved it. Like, I don't actually plan layouts so much on it. I've tried doing that, but it just seems to not work out very well for me with the planning part. But I find that I do, I like to display stuff on it. And sometimes when I have something that I've been working on but I want to walk away from, I'll stick it up on there. And it has little magnetic posts, which I've blinged mine up a lot. So I covered it in the pink washi tape, and I added little gems to the top of the little magnet post. You know, I had to make it mine. And that's been a lot of fun, kind of having that option for displaying things so easily. Okay. So I didn't use these little wooden pieces at all, and I've got lots of lots of great embellishment stuff left. Oh my gosh. Love it. See, I could have used more of these little words and stuff on there too. Okay, so I'm just going to put everything into a big pile so I can tidy that all up after. And I've actually been really good about that lately. Oh, I didn't use that awesome washi tape either. So many good things. I guess it can all fit on one layup, right? I have to say, the Italian restaurant we went to, it was one in the MGM Grand, like, hotel or casino and whatever, and it's called Fiamma, and I had their caprese salad. If you're not familiar with caprese salad, it has, like, fresh, soft mozzarella cheese and tomatoes and basil and usually some balsamic vinaigrette on top of it. Oh my goodness. Theirs was amazing. It was one of the best ones I've had. I don't know if I've had one that good since I was in Italy. So it was very well received from my side of things. Christina says, all the embellishments lead right to the picture. Good job. Perfect. Yay. Yeah, I think that was one of my best ones. So I think the chuck all the embellishments on the onto the page method kind of works out well for me. Go figure. Okay, so now, oh, this is what I could have used for that, for the journaling block. I forgot. I had those little notes, sticky notes. Too many good things. Okay, let's move this out of the way. So next I'm going to work on, oh, next I'm going to do the draw. So don't let me forget that. Oh my gosh. We have lots of people on here, which is exciting. I don't have my friend here like I did last month, so I can just get her to write down all the names. So I'll have to do that myself. It's all good. I've got my lovely flower pot that I use for everything. And let's see. Where is the, okay, there we go. There's the list. Okay, so Allie, Angie, Becky, Bonnie, Brielle, Kathy, Deborah, Diane, Fancy Scrapper, is that Tammy? I always forget when it's like funny name, different names. I don't know, Good Love John's daughter? Jacqueline? And Kathy Carr? Kimberly, Kit, Christina, Rosalind, Roxanne, Shirley, and Susan. Okay, anybody whose name I did not say, speak now or... you won't be entered in the draw. Okay, so let's. Yeah, so this draw will be for one of the kits from Gossamer Blue, and from time to time, the idea was that it was going to be a Life Pages kit. However, sometimes Lori will substitute one of the main kits. So it's kind of like a toss-up as to which one you'll receive, but it will be a lovely, lovely surprise. You can see how wonderful the main kit is. And I think they cost like almost about $35. So all of those items like that I had in that kit I don't think you could, can you buy all of that for $35? I don't know. But I know that I don't have a handy scrapbook store. My scrapbook store that I was shopping at the other day is 2 hours away from where I live. So it's not good. So drum roll, please. Here we go. Let's pick out the lucky winner from the bin. And our lucky winner today is Jacqueline. So that's my horrible spelling for your name, Jacqueline. I might have butchered that a little bit, but you win the kit. Can you please email me and say scrapbook live winner in the subject line? And just I'll need your full mailing information so I can send that on to Lori from Gossamer Blue. So congratulations, Jacqueline. And so that was alice@alicebowl.com. I can type that in the thing down here. And alice@alicebowl.com. That's the place you have to send that. So I'm just gonna put this up here so that I don't forget. Tape it on the side of my flower pot with a little bit of washi tape. There we go. So congratulations. So my next step that I'm going to move on to now is making a Life Pages thing. So let's have a look and see what we have in the Life Pages kit this month. It's always little lovely bits. So let's start with the lovely little bits. And we'll start with the little wood veneer pieces. Oh my gosh, there's lots of them in here. Oh, look at this. There's like a lovely word that says smile. And it's funny because if you get a little dyslexic, you might think it says slime. So don't be dyslexic when you read that. Very different connotations. A little banner edge that says true story. And another one that says it's all good. A little round circle that says noted. Oh, and this one is like one of those little book clips or whatever, like an edge clip, and it has a little heart on it. Super adorable. Around another round circle that says happy. I don't know if you can read that. And another little edge clipping that says that has a star on it. And another little round circle one that says today. So those are super sweet. And they're not so like, they're not like the best day ever kind of thing where you kind of feel that you get stuck in how to use them. Like these feel a lot more usable. Like it's all good is something that I definitely say a lot, so I can see myself using that. It's like it's all good. Just go with the flow. And in this little package there are little acrylic pieces. So let's have a look in here. Okay, so ooh, love them. Okay, they're little golden stars, and if you can see like the detail on that, like they're see-through, you can see right through them, and like they're super delicately cut, like oh my gosh. And there's three of them on here, and they're gold, and on the back they're kind of like a flat gray. So even if you didn't want them gold, you could flip them upside down and plunk them on like that, and you'd have that little bit of a see-through-y edge on them. Absolutely adorable. I totally would use them gold, so I'm expecting to use those. Just looking at them, I'm just like, ooh, ooh, ooh. But you know, that's me. I love the shiny and glittery, and you know, my dad calls me a magpie. Oh, Brielle's holding up the layout. Okay, okay. Can I put you on camera? She says, does that mean yeah?
Okay. This is not on theme, but it was what I was working on, and it's a little home improvement project. So that is it. And just threw on, just like you, a ton of embellishments, but then I always feel better after that. And now I'm gonna have to go because we have a lunch date. So thanks.
Yeah, thank you. I'm so glad you could join us.
Yep.
And thanks for sharing. That's awesome. And I hope you have a fabulous, fabulous lunch. So that's great. Okay, so back to our kit. We also have in here a lovely stamp set. Now the stamp sets that they send out, I have to say, are super duper sweet. So here we have like here and now, and this, and like look at the little cupcake with the heart on it. Oh my gosh. It's kind of perfect for what I'm going to do for the layout today. So that's awesome. There's words like currently, you had me at hello, documented, hello, sweetheart, that's what's up, hashtag love yourself, documented, here and now. And then like this is like, so if you're like unsure about watercolor, or you just want to add like that little dash of color, it looks like a little paintbrush stroke across there. So super cute little stamp set in there. And there is an ephemera pack from Gossamer Blue. So this is their own ephemera pack. So let's have a dig in to see what's in there. Okay, and there is like a little cutout that says January. There is a right now word on there. A little tag that says happy moment. And like I said, it doesn't say like the world's happiest moment ever or something like that. Some cute florals and some hearts. And you've got little banner pieces. This one says hashtag good stuff. Some more little banners. This one says do-over and real life. Trust the process. Take note. Sorry if I don't know where I should hold them up to see them. There's another little banner. There's a couple of little labels in different colors. A begin and an enjoy. It's a couple little arrows. They must know how much I love arrows. I always want to point at something in the pictures, so I love it when I have arrows. There's like tiny, oh my gosh, this is like miniature. Can you see how tiny that is? It's a little word that says this, and another one that says magic, and one that says moment. So this magic moment, they're like totally miniature. I would be careful I don't lose them. A couple of little, tiny little flowers, and a number one, and an ampersand. So perfect. Okay, I'm gonna leave these out.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
I just wanted to say your shirt is so cute.
Thank you. It's a dress. Okay, I'm going to snap and show you. Okay, so this is this lovely dress. Totally.
Oh my gosh.
It's like longer when I pull it down after it's been scooched up.
So cute.
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
Where did you get that?
I got it when I was in Phoenix the 1 year for a ScrapHappy reunion. I went
Oh, how funny.
And just fell in love with it. It's like, okay, and I have to say, like, I love wild and crazy patterns. I'm just like, ooh, that's gregarious. I'm just drawn to stuff like that so much. And yeah, it was like I walked into the store, found the craziest pattern. I'm like, must try that on. And
oh yeah, totally cute.
I fell in love with it. Awesome. Okay, so this little strips of washi tape, so you get like a little mix match. I say mix match a lot, but I think it's mishmash of washi tapes. So cute. And these are branded Gossamer Blue as well. So look at all the stuff that they're doing. They're making their own supplies. This is kind of new. They've made their own stamp sets, but we have seen like the kits have actually had like other companies make the supplies. So I know that Lori had said they were heading in some new directions this year, and it's exciting to see. And then there's this cute like chipboard set with the different things that says like smile. And maybe it's because when I hold this up, when you see this, what it looks the right way, you can read the word smile on there, right? Like you can actually read that. And but when I'm looking at it, it's like reversed. So it's really funny, and I think that's why I'm reading the letters backward. Oh, do we have something happen here? Oh, Roxanne, she's showing off her page. Awesome. She's got her puppy, Dory. I can't read the journaling. Do you want to read it out loud, Roxanne? I don't know if I can hear her. This is cool. They have new features on Zoom.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. It's a dog that we have adopted from my dad. So she's been through a lot since my mom died. So we, my little sweetie, you've been through a lot since the last of your mama. We adopted you since Papa can't take care of you. I think you like it here. The boys love you. So it was for load 26, the prompt. Thank you.
Can I say hello?
Awesome. Well, thanks so much.
Can I say hello, Mama?
Okay. Thank you so much, Roxanne. That was awesome. I love seeing all the pages that people are creating. Okay, this looks a little different. That's funny. Here we go. Oh, I think I've got to go and exit full screen there for me. There we go. That looks a little bit more manageable. Okay, so let's have a quick peek through the actual cards that are in here. And I love it. The colors on this. This looks crazy. Okay, I have to show you. I love it. Okay, so they got this card that says, let's do this. And if you look at the letters, they actually are red and pink. And, you know, it seems like that's like the break all the rules kind of thing. But on that black background, that just looks awesome. I just love it. Let's do this. And of course, like if you're not familiar with their cards, they do like a vertical on one side and like a horizontal on the other, and usually with the same kind of pattern. So you have here a floral and same kind of floral. Here we have the coffee with the heart and the coffee with the heart kind of thing. And some other little simple patterns, which is awesome. And sorry, I'm trying to like get through and show them fairly easy. I'm trying to do my best little Vanna White thing here and flip things over. This one here actually has a different color on the other side, which is a fun option. Look at this floral. So this side here has like a dark pattern in the background, and this side here has a light pattern in the background. That was really fun. The whole story. There's a card that says today. Look how bold that is. Like that's a super bold one. And then, oops, today. Oh, we've got lots of questions. That's good. Roxanne's answering questions about her stuff, about the things that she used on her layout. Don't worry, be happy. There's lots of these little cards. And they have, like, this one actually has, like, little dotted lines at the bottom so they can do your journaling. I like it when they include a few more cards that you can fit some journaling onto. This is nice. Like, it's got subtle embellishments on it, but still plenty of room to write your journaling on it. Love, love, love. Some simple lines. Oh, snap. And it's done with, like, those cute little marquee letters. Some dots, and it says today, oops, like this. And this one has like the days of the week kind of marked on it. And this one says good. And here we go, the best ever. And this one's cute. It has like barn board, but like a really dark, maybe not barn board, maybe it's like hardwood flooring, but it's like really dark. Cool. And then there are some big cards as well. So we've got this one here. It has like the days of the week listed on the bottom. Same kind of thing. You can flip them over. Look at this marquee letter for February. Beautiful. And hey there. And we've got, this is a fun kind of geometric kind of pattern. You see the small detail on that? And this cool chevron, multicolored chevron. And then one of these black and white florals. So I actually saw a few black and white floral kind of lines when I went to CHA last month, and I kind of love it. I haven't played a lot with them yet, so I'm kind of excited to do some of that. Okay, so I've got lots of options in here. Plus, I have the printables page. Where did I set that? Good question. That's the one I've already chopped. It's probably at the bottom of the pile. Oh, here it is. So this is the printables page that comes with it. And the printables come in PDF or PNG format, I think, so that you can get both of them. And I think that you can use those, one of those, like, is it the PNG that you can use, like, with a cutting machine? Somebody might be a little more familiar. I tend to be a little lazy with that kind of stuff, so that you could print and cut them right out. Or use them digitally, I believe. So yeah, lots of good little options with words and stuff on here. So let's have a look and I'll show you what I'm planning. So I'm actually just planning to do a single page for this today. I've got some other pictures that I need to get off from my husband for February, but the first thing that kind of happened this month is that my son on the 1st of February turns 18. I can't believe that that happened already. So I have these pictures of him, like one with him with his brother from the morning time, and then the cake. And we actually took him to a casino because here in Alberta, we can go to a casino when you're 18. We just went to dinner and then my brother was showing him how to play roulette, which might sound bad, but he totally lost everything. My brother gave him $50 to spend and he could only keep his winnings, which he didn't get enough of to bring anything home. So it was like a really good lesson for life. Gambling does not pay. And I have like a little individual shot of him. So the back of my last page that I have here in my pocketbook, maybe I'll just pull that up and show you. So last month I had done this layout here for January and I had kind of scrapbooked mostly about my husband's birthday, which was last month. And, you know, we went go-karting and then we went bowling for his birthday. And, you know, most of this page kind of went around that with the fireworks from New Year's kind of thing. So it didn't really fulfill most of that month. I felt like I had still kind of missed out a lot of the month for that. Am I holding up the right page? I'm not even, this one isn't the one that goes with that. That's hilarious. Here we go. So this one and this one. No, I'm holding the right one. Yeah, the bowling in that. Okay. So then I felt like I still needed to fill in the rest of January. So I put together this little quick page for part of it. And this was like the rest of kind of January. This is not showing very well. Okay, so this was the rest of January. My son went and dyed his hair blue. Deep breath on my mother. For my mother's heart, it was like, what have you done to your beautiful hair? He has like this, he had this beautiful like golden hair, but he kind of bleached it and dyed it blue. And I was like, oh, what have you done? Oh no. But it turned out really splotchy and he wasn't happy with the results. So he dyed it like dark. So now it's like a dark kind of brownish color. And I'm like, that just is a lot easier to live with, but it's still so weird to see him with dark hair because he was my super blondie baby. So I've been able to fill in a few more things and I found a little card that said, try new things. And he's been teaching himself how to play the piano recently. My other son went to a swim meet and swam his first distance event. He swam an 800 meter, which is not his event. So let's just say he didn't have a great time with it, but you know, it still was a new thing for him. And then on the matching page, I had kind of done a bit about going to the Creativation event down in Phoenix. And I included my little cards, like the business card that I had made up. And I talked about making the video for the ScrapHappy update where I took them on a sledding adventure down the hill for our January update. and just talked a little bit about, you know, that for the month. So I have the back of this page to kind of work with today. And I have, so it has three large vertical pockets and then six horizontal pockets. And I think that that's just what I'm going to do. And I think I'll just make the first half like of this page just focusing on my son's birthday and when I get the rest of our Vegas trip. That was kind of the two main things that happened here in February. When I get the rest of those pictures off my husband, then I can fill in like the Vegas side of things on the opposite side. So for today, I'll just do like the one side. So I've got these two pictures that are like vertical kind of photos. And if I wanted, like I could probably cut this one into a horizontal as well. So that's kind of one of my options, depending on what the cards look like and how it all is playing out. And then I've got these two little mini ones that I just need to clip apart. So that's where that's going to start off with. And I saw some birthday-ish stuff or things that I thought could go well with a birthday, which was good, being that that's what this is. And I don't know if I'll do like maybe a page for his own book that includes some birthday stuff for him. I like the idea of that. So we'll see what happens. I find that scrapbooking birthdays is usually not something I'm good at doing. Like I just don't seem inspired. It doesn't seem like I have a story so much to tell. But I did do a page. Oh, do I have it handy here? No. I did do a page kind of for his 18th birthday where I did like this collage of all these pictures of him growing up. And I really loved that part. So we've got some extra audio going on here. I don't know what's happening there. Okay. So there, yeah. So that's going to be the start. I've just laid the pictures down and we'll see what that turns into. But for now, I think that's off to a good start. So I'm going to poke through the cards and have a look. I would like something that says January or February, sorry, not January. I really like this and I'm not as fond of this where the word is all broken up like that. I don't love it as much, but I still think like the feeling of it is pretty good. So it might go on there. I also have that little wood veneer from the other kit that said February as well with the marquee letter. So that might be another option. So if I go with that, then I just need my little stack here. The best ever. That might work for a good birthday, actually. That might be one of the few times that you can use the best ever. Celebrate the everyday. This is more of a birthday, so I don't know about the everyday. This is very bold. If that's the right thing, but I can try. Let's do this. Okay. Oh, that's kind of cute. It's like the month of February and it has the heart on the 14th for Valentine's Day. That's kind of sweet. Okay. So this is looking okay. I've picked out a few cards here, but I'm still missing like one spot, so I don't know what I'm feeling for that. Just try a couple things in here. I I really liked the chevron, actually. This one right here. And I think I could just cut that down and use that on there. And I think I would like that even more, actually, than this little monthly thing. So I think I'm going to do that. So that kind of looks okay. And maybe I want that chevron on there, maybe not. I'll kind of give myself that option. I could maybe use this little simple background as well. And then I can look at what I have for like pretty little things. So open up the stamp set. I'm gonna need some black ink, I think, because yeah, the base color on this is black. And it does have the little cupcake on it, which is adorable. And let's see, I've got those little stars that I know that I wanted to use on here. Oh, there's a little heart on here and a little circle in the chipboard, and it says, it's just the beginning. And if that isn't a perfect sentiment for, you know, a kid that's just turning 18 and just kind of starting out with life, it's just like, oh, that's kind of great. So I'm contemplating putting it right on the photo up here. Or maybe on the outside of the pocket. I'm not sure. I might just put it right on the photo itself. And let's see, maybe a little banner. Because if I just float this onto the photo, I think it's gonna look like it's just kind of floating there. So if I have like a little banner, maybe even a piece of the washi tape, instead of looking like it's floating, it'll kind of feel like it's tied down a little bit. Okay. Oh, yeah, I think this washi tape might be just the right thing. So that's black and white, so I can kind of do anything on here. Okay, so this one says, hello, hello, hello. I'm just gonna tear the end of it so that I have that torn edge kind of look. And then I'm going to cut another little piece of it off. And I gotta see how big that chunk is. That's explosive. And so how far do I want to have it sticking? Okay, and then I'll just wrap that to the back of the photo. So I've just added just a little strip like that right on the photo. You know, if I absolutely hated it, whatever, I print another photo and it's not like a big deal, right? So this looks like it has adhesive backing, and yet I'm ripping it right off because it's not seeming to come off. So I'm gonna need some different adhesive to stick that on there. That's one thing with chipboard that happens a lot, is sticking it down can kind of suck. I'm just using my stabby stabber to get that open. There, it's just the beginning. Oh, I love that. Okay, it's good. So that'll go on there. Maybe I'll move my words over to here, put this big bright one over, and then I'll be able to do this one here. That looks a little bit better with the whole balance of the page, I think. And think about what I need to actually write on here. Probably not tons of stuff. I could put this big smile in the middle, unless there's something else. Okay, where's the cupcake gonna go? I think I'm gonna stamp it over here. I'd like to stamp it with one of the colors to make it a little bit brighter. So I've got like this red in here. I've got a blue. There's definitely a pink and purple. I think I kind of like the purple if I can find a color. So he actually has a little bit of that purple on his shirt too. Okay, so when you have a new stamp, it really helps if you stamp it off onto something else a few times. So you kind of have to break them in, and called seasoning your stamps. Otherwise, what you end up with is, let's see here. You see how it's like really not filled in, it's really kind of fuzzy and everything like that. You get that look when stamps aren't seasoned and they're not kind of broken in and ready. So when you want your stamps to work a little bit better, you really have to get them kind of broken in and seasoned. And it's almost there now. Some people like to try to pick up oils from their hand or their skin, but I don't want to really bring that into my stuff. Oh, that's giving me a really cool look. As I'm rubbing it across, it's creating lines on there. Oh, who said that? Jacqueline says, I finished a 2-page layout. Awesome. Okay. Okay, let's stamp that on there. And I'm going to just have a quick, oops, that's not very good. I'm gonna throw that away. Okay, so I've got the cake stamped on there. I thought there was like a word. No, there wasn't. Oh, happy day. Yeah, let's stamp that on there too. And chuck that away already. I've got somebody's mute. It's not on. Hearing the background noises. There we go. Sure, the stamp's good. There we go. That looks perfect. So that's the stamps, and I can fill in this info on here. Happy day, date. Okay, so that looks good. journaling, maybe a little of this. Okay, I'm going to stick these little stars on here because now that I've just kind of plunked them on there, I'm enjoying that placement a little bit. I think it kind of works. Just a little fun. And here we go. Yeah, I love these little acrylic pieces. I don't know, I'm kind of obsessed with them lately. They've been some of my favorite pieces in the kits and even in the individual supplies I've purchased lately. Okay, what am I forgetting? Oh, I'm forgetting about my little wooden embellishments.
Hey, Alice.
Hey.
So I haven't journaled yet, but if you can see it.
I'm going to put you on the spotlight video.
Oh, okay, there you go. Let me back up some. There you go.
Hey. Oh, the frozen waterfall. It's beautiful.
Yeah. So I'm going to do the journaling over here, and that'll be it, and the date.
Love it.
Okay.
Thanks for sharing.
You're welcome.
Anybody else want to share while we're here? Any other pages? Just double checking, making sure we don't have anybody else that's saying, hey, got my hand up. Not that you have to put your hand up. Just give me a shout and say, hey, it's all good. I'm just checking these little things. Oh, there's like a little thing that says happy. Okay, I'm gonna put that on there.
One more thing. So, you know, as a vacation, but it wasn't like a big enough for a whole album. But if you do all your pages the same, then it kind of blends together. So here was the day before when we went to the lake. So you see how it's like the same. They kind of match.
The color theme.
Yeah, it's the same paper pack.
So then when you're flipping through your album, that part all kind of feels cohesive, right? You can tell that that's together, but it's not necessarily like you needed a whole album for that one event. I love it. That's a really good tip. Oh, Jacqueline says, I can show mine. Perfect. I'll put you up. Spotlight. And, okay, can we hear you?
I don't know. Can you?
Yes. Yes, I can.
I've got a lot of glare going on, but Christmas for cats is what.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. I love it. Is that background paper, like, is it kind of shiny, too? Like,
it's just black embossed cardstock, but I'm facing a window.
Okay. Black and... But it's embossed, so it has like texture embossed or, okay.
It's got a chevron embossing.
Yeah, okay, I love it. I could see it a little bit more when you were holding up the other page and I'm like, ooh, I like that paper.
There we go.
Yeah. Awesome. Also, it's like Christmas and pets. Like you've got to that all put together. Cool, and then I see that you've got like journaling strips on there. Did you type on there?
I did cut it into strips.
Yeah,
that's typed in on strips.
Yeah, see the strips, it makes it so easy when you're using those typewriters.
It does, because when I made the mistakes, I just hit return and started a new line.
That's exactly what had happened to me, and I'm like, okay, I've got to figure out how to do this, because I'm not going to be happy with that. So that's awesome. Well, thank you so much for sharing. I love this so much. I love getting to see what everybody's creating and getting that all put back together. It's awesome. So I might put that on there. How do I? I wanted to use one of these little clip things, but with the layers, I don't know if I can. If I put one on here, it's going to stick up over top of the thing. I don't really want that sticking out of my album. It's not like a thing that I've been doing in my album, is having like little tabs and stuff sticking out. So I'm not sure. I could probably, no, I don't know. I could probably have it sticking out of, oh, not that pocket, though. It's not. That's a side mount pocket, so that's definitely not going to work. So maybe that's not going to work on here. I'm just testing little embellishments, so. Let's see. Let's have a look through this little kit, too. And see if I have more stuff. So I've got a little bit of... Okay, some hearts, the tag, the enjoy mate work right now, hashtag good stuff. Begin, do over. Okay, oh, and arrows. Oh, I think I want to put this magic moment on this picture of my boys hugging, because I sure don't get that photo a lot. So I think it's going to have to go onto a little piece of a strip or something like that. Yeah. Oh my gosh, these are so tiny. They're almost like impossible to move around. And was there like a little star or something? Oh, maybe I could tap that onto there and then have that so it still fits. I think that would work. Okay, let's stick these on here first. I don't even know what to use for adhesive, they're so tiny. This magic, oh God, and now I've got it on the counter. Everybody else is this coordinated too, right? I don't pretend to be like professional and awesome at this. Just in case you were getting that impression, let's say real life lives here. There's glue all over the counter and pieces ended up all over the place. If by the end of this I'm not stuck to the layout, then I consider that a win. I guess that's staying there already. Cool. Now I can put this on here. Oh no, it doesn't quite fit. If I trim down into that, it would go. I really want to use one of these things, but I can't quite read the thing. So, mark it with my pencil. It's right here. Yeah, if it goes down a little bit further, it will work. Of course, I picked the pencil that has the faulty lead. Crowd back in a second. Okay. I swear I'm going to win with this because I'll be stubborn. So I'm going to win. Okay. cut out that little middle so this can go on here and go down there. Okay, I just need to cut out a little touch more top of that, and it looks great. Okay, so here's what I did. Okay, so I've got this little piece and I've attached my this magic moment onto there. And then I decided I wanted to put this little wood veneer piece on there, and it kind of slides right on over top. So obviously I need to put this around, but I had to trim into this little bit of the frame to make it work. Maybe hold it right there, you can kind of see. So I had to kind of trim into that so that when I slide this on, it can go down far enough so that you can still read that little bit. And then I'm gonna attach this right onto this photo of the boys hugging, because that is a special little moment. And that's just going to go, I think I'll just wrap it right around there. If I thought a little bit more, I would have left a little bit more of this tab there, but I didn't, and I think that it will be okay. Actually, I'm just gonna trim it right off. So that's gonna go on right there. That's gonna look super cute. And then I found a way to use that little piece so that it still fits onto this layout, which is cute. Actually, I did this. And trim this off and make it fool onto the other one so I can make it just a little bit longer. Ta-da! Total cheat and totally awesome. Yep, that's what's happening. Okay, so I'll put it too close to the end of the banner. So I've cut off the extra side of the banner. Now I can just put this on and it looks like it's part of that banner. It's totally perfect, and I love it. Okay, it's a little bit too deep. Perfect. Well, that went well. Awesome. And that just fits right onto that top of that corner. And this and that, the stamps. I almost want like something a little bit more colorful on there. Need to put my journaling. I think I am gonna cut this out and put this on here. So I'm going to make it 3 inches. I think I'm gonna put that on some foam tape to pop it up a little bit. There we go. This layout's coming together and it's almost done. I'm pretty excited. My garbage maybe should be a little bit closer to me because I keep reaching way over. Put that right there. Good, so I've got my smile popped up on the chevron card that was cut from the big chevron, but that works. And just checking my little bits, see if there was anything else that I felt like was meant to be used. I like this little purple. This is good stuff. No, that doesn't fit. Okay. No, I think that's it for those little bits. Let me just check that printed sheet again and see. I'm gonna set it now. Keep setting it underneath something. No, I don't think any of those are really what I'm needing for this. That's okay. Okay, so now a little bit of journaling on here, and this will be done. So I can start tucking it into pockets. Okay. On the outside. I find that the more pocket pages that I create, the better and easier I am at putting them, like the easier, better I am at putting them together and the easier it's getting to put them together. I do want this, no, I want this over here. I'll get it. Eventually I'll get it. Journaling's gonna go there. And this one's going in over here. Ooh, these are tight cards. Okay. So I just need to do my journaling up on here, but I think I'll do that after so I can just spend some time on that rather than have like dead air time. There we go. That's the page for his 18th birthday. And maybe I'll find an 18 or something to stick on something just to make it like a little bit more, you know, relevant. But I think, oh, I have those little letters. Maybe I'll use those puffy letters. So yeah, I think it turned out really good. So a quick review. I've got the layout that I made from the life or from the main kit. And the pocket page I made with the Life Pages kit. And it all came together pretty well. So just on here with some journaling. Okay, that's it. This is, I'm calling that done. I think it totally worked. Okay, well, if you were here joining me today, that's awesome. Jacqueline was our winner of the prize for today. So I want to make sure that you send me the email if you haven't already. Don't forget, alice@alicebull.com. She's like waving. She's like, yay. And Lori's really good about getting them out right away. It might take a couple of minutes longer for yours to arrive because you're in Canada like me. I know that. So, but it won't take too long. And I just wanted to say, like, next month we are doing this again. It won't be at the end of the month. I've been creating my schedule already, and my son has a gigantic provincial swim meet next month, and then we also have a little trip planned. So it's going to be earlier in the month than normal, so watch for that. I'm actually crossing my fingers big time that the mail is very cooperative and that I'll get my Gossamer Blue kit on time. If not, I will not be working with the Gossamer Blue kit, but it should come in. So cross your fingers for me. I'm all good with that. And I look forward to seeing you next month. I just wanted to say thank you. I hope that you're getting your projects done. You can see several of the gals were scrapbooking alongside. I hope that everybody else was. And I really love this live interactive crop kind of event. So thanks for joining me for Scrapbook Live, and I'll be back again next month. And if you're interested in what we do with ScrapHappy, you notice like I know several of the girls that were here. Check out scraphappy.org. We are a super friendly group and we do a lot of live interactive things in our group every month so that, you know, we can get our scrapbooking done. And then we also have our load challenges. So that's super fun too. Okay, well, I will talk to everybody later, and happy scrapping.